Bonjour à tous. Hello, everyone. I want to begin by addressing the news that hundreds of unmarked graves have been found near the former residential school in Cowessess First Nation. This was an incredibly harmful government policy that was Canada's reality for many, many decades. And Canadians today are horrified and ashamed of how our country behaved, but a policy that ripped kids from their homes, from their communities, from their culture and their language, and forced assimilation upon them. This is a piece of our past, of decades past, that resonates and echoes and is and continues to be a lived reality of consequences for many, many Canadians today. So, specifically to the members of the Cowessess community and Treaty 4 communities, we are sorry. It was something that we cannot undo in the past, but we can pledge ourselves every day to fix in the present and into the future. And that means recognizing the harms, the impacts, the intergenerational trauma, the cycles of challenges that far too many Indigenous peoples face in this country because of actions that the federal government and other partners deliberately and willingly undertook. I spoke with Chief Cadmus Delorme yesterday, the Chief of Cowessess First Nations, and offered all of the federal government's continued support and partnership, not just on supporting the communities that are grieving for the discovery of these graves, but also on the work that we must do to help them heal, to create opportunities to move forward, including on the issue of child and family services. We know that even long after residential schools closed in this country, child and family service, in the stated purpose of protecting children's well-beings, continued to take them away from their communities, continued to remove them from their language and culture, and place them in foster homes in non-Indigenous communities all across the country. That's why one of the calls of the Truth and Reconciliation Commission was to restore the care of kids at risk to the communities themselves. And in my conversation with Chief Cadmus, Chief Delorme, we talked directly about how we could even further accelerate the great work that Cowessess has already been doing on moving forward on child and family services as an example of the kind of work that is being done right across the country and in recognition of the terrible time that the community is going through right now. This has come on the heels of the terrible news out of Kamloops, and it has caused a lot of Canadians to reflect on our past and how it has impacts on our present, to have difficult conversations with their loved ones, with their kids, about Canada's history and Canada's present. Truth and reconciliation requires that we start with truth, and we start by recognizing the terrible, terrible mistake that we willingly undertook in the past, taking kids from their homes and communities and leaving them open to incredible challenges and hardship as we tried to remove their languages and cultures from them. With Canada Day coming up next week, a lot of people, I think, will be reflecting on many different things. Reflecting on the really tough year we just had with COVID-19. How much we lost, how much we learned, how much we've been there for each other through difficult times. But at the same time, many, many Canadians will be reflecting on reconciliation, on our relationship with Indigenous peoples and how it has evolved and how it needs to continue to evolve rapidly. We have so many things we need to work on together. And I think this Canada Day, it will be a time of reflection on what we've achieved as a country, but on what more we have to do. So as we gather with family and friends, carefully still, and reflect on our past, we need to understand and remind ourselves that Canada didn't happen by accident, and it won't continue without effort. And this coming Canada Day, I think we all need to pledge ourselves to doing what we can to continue that effort to make Canada better, all the while respecting and listening to those for whom it's not yet a day of celebration. I think all of us need to aspire and work hard to get to the point where everyone across this country will be able to celebrate fully all that this great country is and all it will be able to continue to be into the coming years, and know that if we're going to be that, we all have more work to do, because that's the story of Canada, always stepping up with more work to do. Yesterday, I also talked with National Chief Bellegarde, because tragically, Cowessess is not the only place in this country where children died in the residential school system. It's not the only place where children faced abuse, loneliness, illness, and neglect. So to all families and survivors across the country, I know that no words can right these terrible wrongs. It is with our actions that we need to continue to recognize the truth and to do everything we can to support you. Following the discovery at the former Kamloops residential school earlier this month, we've made $27 million available immediately to Indigenous communities to find and honour children who died at these institutions. For communities in Saskatchewan in particular, like Cowessess, we've reached an agreement with the Federation of Sovereign Indigenous Nations to provide almost $4.9 million to search for burial sites. And for people across the country, we're providing whatever mental health support survivors, families, and communities need for healing. Le système de pensionnat a été conçu pour effacer les langues et les cultures autochtones. Quand je discute avec des dirigeants et des membres des communautés, on parle souvent de l'importance de prendre des mesures concrètes pour réparer ces torts. C'est exactement la raison pour laquelle on a fait adopter la loi sur les langues autochtones, qui est une étape essentielle sur le chemin de la réconciliation, et on continue d'aller de l'avant. Lundi, j'ai eu une rencontre avec le commissaire et les directeurs du tout premier bureau du commissaire aux langues autochtones. Notre travail en partenariat se poursuit afin de permettre aux cultures et aux langues autochtones de s'épanouir et de se développer. Il en reste beaucoup à faire pour rectifier les erreurs du passé et éliminer les écarts qui existent encore aujourd'hui. En tant que gouvernement, on va toujours être là pour accomplir le travail nécessaire, mais nous nous devons tous de continuer à faire partie de ce progrès, de ces avancées sur le chemin de la réconciliation. La semaine prochaine, c'est la fête du Canada. Et ça nous donne l'occasion de réfléchir non seulement à l'année extrêmement difficile par laquelle on vient juste de passer, mais aussi à l'histoire du Canada et son impact sur le présent, particulièrement pour les communautés autochtones. Il y a des gens qui voudront pas et pourront pas célébrer la fête du Canada cette année, et nous devons les écouter, les respecter et s'engager à en faire encore plus, à réfléchir au pays que nous sommes et au pays qu'on veut être, et savoir que chacun d'entre nous a son rôle à jouer pour avancer, pour continuer de devenir et d'être le meilleur pays au monde. This morning, I also want to share an update about where we are in the fight against this pandemic. And to begin with, I have some good news about vaccine deliveries. We committed to reaching 9.1 million Pfizer doses delivered to Canada in July as part of our summer ramp-up. We've now received confirmation of our July vaccine delivery schedule from Pfizer, and it provides us the clear path to reach that goal. In other words, we're keeping our commitment. Of course, we've shared these delivery details with the provinces and territories so that they can get doses into arms as soon as they arrive. Canada is leading the world on vaccination. Over 76% of eligible Canadians have had at least a first dose, and over 26% have had a second. But let's keep that momentum up. Remember, you need a second dose to stay safe. It's not something you can do halfway. Just like by now everybody knows the mask goes over your nose and mouth, we all have to get that second shot once we've gotten our first. En ce qui concerne les vaccins, on va avoir reçu un total de plus de 68 millions de doses d'ici la fin juillet. Ça fait beaucoup de vaccins. C'est la voie à suivre pour vaincre cette pandémie au Canada. À ce sujet, plus tard aujourd'hui, la Dr Tam va présenter un modèle à jour des prédictions du nombre de cas pour les prochaines semaines. Au cours des 15 derniers mois, ces modèles n'ont pas toujours donné lieu à de bonnes nouvelles. Mais parce que les gens se font vacciner, parce que les gens sont restés à la maison et ont suivi les règles de santé publique, la situation actuelle est plutôt encourageante. Si on reste sur cette lancée, en faisant attention et en se faisant vacciner, le nombre de cas va continuer à diminuer. Ça veut dire qu'on va pouvoir continuer à aller de l'avant, prudemment, avec la réouverture. Alors, faites-vous vacciner. Quand ce sera votre tour, ça va vous protéger et protéger votre famille, votre communauté, et ça va tous nous permettre de se rapprocher de la fin de cette crise. Now, before I end for today, I want to take a moment to talk to all the kids out there who are starting their summer break. It's been a tough year. I know that. I spent a lot of time watching my grade one Hadrian trying to stay focused on a computer with his Lego beside him as he's getting through grade one. And nobody wants to have gone through an entire school year like this, but so many of you have. You've been incredibly strong. You've figured out how to help around the family, help around the house, help your mom and dad in difficult times, stay focused on school even though it was totally different. You've missed your friends, but you've found ways to play with them virtually. We've all made incredible sacrifices this year, but you have made an awful lot as kids. So I want to say thank you, that we're proud of you. Your parents are proud of you. Your teachers are proud of you. And Canada is proud of everything you did to help us get through this year and hopefully end this pandemic very soon. So you've earned a better summer. Yes, we'll still have to be careful, and it won't entirely be normal as a summer, but it'll be pretty great. We're all looking forward to getting back outside and having fun with our friends, and we're going to be able to do an awful lot of that this summer because you stayed focused on helping, on being there, and on getting us all through it. And to parents and teachers, thank you. I know it's really been tough as well. And I know if, again, you're like my household, you're busy thinking about how we're going to get our kids away from those screens that were so integral to their daily lives over the past many, many months, and actually have them play together and play outside and drop some of those electronic habits. But we have gotten through this. We're not quite done. We still need to be careful and vigilant, and will for quite a while. But things are so much better because Canadians pulled together. Thank you for everything you've done, for your kids, for your students, for our communities. Thank you for having their backs, as we will continue to have yours. Notre gouvernement a investi des milliards de dollars pour apporter aux élèves, aux enseignants et au personnel l'aide dont ils avaient besoin. Par exemple, pour le conseil scolaire du district d'Algoma en Ontario, ce financement a permis de faire une série de mises à niveau pour améliorer la ventilation et l'éclairage. À la rentrée, les élèves vont donc pouvoir retrouver des classes plus sécuritaires et mieux adaptées à leurs besoins. L'année a été difficile pour tout le monde. Mais on va continuer d'investir pour être certain que les enfants, les parents, les travailleurs et tout le monde puissent revenir en force. Merci beaucoup.